Hey, TheEzeJC here, and today we'll be doing a small tutorial about OBS and how to get the audio to work. Because if you've ever been with OBS, you would know that if you ever have background audio, such as game sound or something like that, you cannot hear the audio through OBS. So for example, if I play Crab Rave over here on YouTube and I go over here to OBS, OBS says that I do not have Crab Rave open, as is there is no background noise. Now there are solutions as to Soundflower and iShowUAudio, but those two things have not worked for me. So I have settled to work for an answer, and here's what I found. Alright, so the first thing you're gonna do is go over here to this URL and download ScreenFlake. Now this program you can download for free, and we're only gonna use the plugin required in this program. So once you're over here in this website, which is gonna be linked down in the description down below, you're gonna click download. Once you download it here, it's gonna download as a .zip file. And once you have the .zip file, what you're gonna do is double click it and open it. Once you have this thing open, you're gonna go and drag and drop the ScreenFlake file over here to applications. Now I'm not gonna do that because I already have it downloaded, but once you have that installed, what you're gonna do is open ScreenFlake. Alright, so once you have ScreenFlake open, you're gonna see that there's gonna be a message that's telling you to buy it or register it. You do not want to register it, so say not yet. Once you're here in the home menu, what you're gonna do here is go to audio extensions and click on the plugin. Now over here it's gonna ask you whether or not you have to install it or not. Now, obviously, I already have it installed, so you're gonna click install if you don't have it. Once you have this thing installed, it's gonna go over here and it's gonna open a new PKG. Just gonna install it over here on the Mac boot drive. And once you have the Mac installed, this program called Screen Loop Lab Plugin, what you're gonna do is open audio.midi. So once you have audio MIDI opened and ScreenFlake Loopback installed, you're gonna know if it's installed or not, because you're gonna see the ScreenFlake Loopback appear here in audio devices. So what you're going to do next in here is you're going to create a multi-output device. So once you have the multi-output device selected, what you're going to select is the built-in output and ScreenFlake Loopback. You're not going to have straight-to-stream audio capture because that's what I'm currently recording with. But we're going to select those two. Once you have those two selected, you're going to right-click on the left side, drift correction to built-in output. So you're going to use Screen Loopback and you're going to use built-in output and you're going to drift the correction to built-in output. And once you're here, you're going to set the master device over here to built-in output. Nothing else and nothing more. Once you have that done, you're going to close out audio MIDI. You're going to go back to OBS and you're going to open it. So once you're in OBS, what you're going to have to do is right click on and let's go to settings. Once you're in settings, you're going to go over here to audio. And you're going to make sure that both desktops are disabled, but instead, you're gonna add a new microphone. This microphone is gonna be where the audio capture is gonna go through. So once you're gonna right click on it, you're gonna select ScreenFlake Loopback. Once you have it selected, click apply or close, and once that's selected, you are set. And now what you have to do is you have to select the audio device to be selected on your Mac. So there are two ways to do this. One, you can right click and hold the audio icon here, and once you have it selected, you're gonna click multi-output device. Once you have a multi-output device, you're gonna see that this thing is not grayed out, and that means it's selected. And now if you don't have this thing and you can't right click hold on it, you can also go into settings here. Right, so you can also go into settings here, go into sound. Once you're in sound, you're gonna go over here to output. And from output, you're gonna click multi-output device, or device, the thing you just created. Once you're there, you're gonna have a selected. So now that you have a selected, you're gonna go up here to OBS, and there you go. As you can see, in OBS, mic is currently not moving, that's because I don't have any sound. But if I go over here to YouTube and play Crab Rave again. Alright guys, so here's proof of me actually doing it. Now, the reason it didn't work was because I was currently recording, and if I start recording, this thing is not gonna work. But you can see here, the meter over here is moving here in the background, which means it's currently working. So I have multi-output device selected, which means, so this top here is the microphone. So that's the microphone, this is the game sound. So if I switch devices, you can see that it's not gonna work anymore, but if I go back over here to multi-output device, it should proceed to work, as you can see right here. Right then, so once you have the multi-output device selected and you have OBS open, you should be able to hear the music here in the background, but since I am currently recording with another program, you will not be able to hear it. Now you don't have to keep ScreenFlake installed, you can uninstall it. The only reason we installed ScreenFlake was because we needed the plugin. But now that we have the plugins, I didn't really need it. But if you want to show your support to the company, please just buy it and actually support them. Because these are the only ways in which you're doing this. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please subscribe. And besides that, I will see you all in the next video. Bye bye.